Good morning, everyone. I am so glad you are tuning in today. I have a very special guest for you today, and I cannot wait to introduce her to you. Now, Wendy and I met online on Planet Internet, as one of our mutual friends and mentors would say, and we immediately connected. And we've been talking lately about all sorts of really cool things, which we'll get more into on today's video. And if you're listening live, you're catching the replay, or maybe you're listening over on the podcast, say hello, pop in, let us know you're here, ask us your questions. We would love to interact with you. So my friends, if we haven't met yet, if this is your first time here watching a video or listening to a podcast, my name is Young Pratt. I am a 17-year performing arts studio owner turned chief dreamer, author, and podcaster right here at Our Young Creators. Here at OIC, we are so passionate about equipping kids with real-world skills so that they can share their talents, their stories, and be a voice for good in a world that definitely needs more positivity. And our guest today is Wendy Livingston Guth. She is CEO of Rebel on the Go, where she creates memorable event and travel experiences for women trying to shake whatever is holding them back. She became an entrepreneur following a 30-plus year in the meetings industry. Wendy currently lives in Guantanamo Bay, Cuba, with her twin tweens, and she recently began homeschooling them and loves creating lasting, memorable experiences with them. While I'm bringing Wendy onto the show, please say hi and let us know you are here. Hello, Wendy. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. I'm so excited to be here.
As am I. We got an opportunity last week to connect in real life, well, not in real life, in real time using technology. And my mind is still reeling from our conversation because it was so, so good.
Yes. Yes. It was amazing to talk about all of the opportunities that are available for what we can do for our kids, both in real time and online, and the skills. And oh yeah, I was sort of antsy all weekend talking about it. My husband was like, okay.
Yes, moving on. Yeah, I can totally relate to that. Sometimes we get so excited about opportunities and ideas we have when we connect with our biz besties online, and sometimes the rest of the world just doesn't get that, right?
That's very true. Very, very true. But I went through the program, your program with the kids, and it was like, I want more. I want to see what else that they can do and what else that we can do as a family. And yeah, it gets the juices flowing, which, well, yeah, last week you just put a little fire under me
too. So good. I love conversations like that. And I want to backtrack a little bit. Mm-hmm. You were jumping into an experience we had together. And I want to just let everyone know that Wendy and her kids recently went through our 8-week program on becoming a podcast family. It was a live interactive course where my daughter Daphne and I got to work together side by side with your beautiful family to show you all the steps that you need to take to put together a podcast, and beyond that, to really create memories that we're going to bond you together, ways you can capture your memories, and ways that you can use your voice and your kids' voices to really make an impact in the world.
Mm-hmm. Oh yes, very much so. And it's so exciting to see And really, it's only what your imagination restricts you. You know, it's absolutely wide open. The kids were, they think of themselves as like YouTubers, which I'm still not sure I know what that means, but that's okay. And and they enjoy the technology, which I remember in high school being told I had to take some computer class, and I was like, what? So it's fantastic that it's really taking the skills that they just seem to flock to now and being able to develop it into something mm-hmm. that means something. And that while they're having fun too, which is important. Yeah.
Absolutely. It's definitely easier for them to do more things if they're excited about it.
Yes, very much so. Very much so. Yeah, especially, when you homeschool, they think of everything as being homework and being mandatory and all of that. And it's not really. I mean, granted, I was happy to incorporate the course into the curriculum that mm-hmm. they had, but it's not as challenging. There were moments that, but it's not as considered as torturous as, say, science or, oh no, math. Yeah. So it definitely gave them a break to actually do something that they enjoy and learn something. And that whole concept of them getting paid for it really was very exciting to them.
Absolutely. And that was one of my favorite lessons, right? Because yes. I could just see their eyes getting bigger and bigger and bigger. We talked about all the possibilities on how they can take the skills that they were learning to serve not only themselves and create things for them, but to also then use those same skills to go out there, find someone who needs some help and serve mm-hmm. them in a big way.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. And, it takes them a quarter of the time in a lot of respects that it takes for me to do things. Mm-hmm. I think of myself as being fairly technologically savvy, but not completely. So I'm happy when I can turn things over or teach them things that they in turn can. And it teaches them skills, but also responsibility and things of that nature. So yeah, it's a wonderful opportunity.
Absolutely. So many good things that I've seen come around by our time together. I would love to know, what was it about this experience, about this topic, that made you say, yes, I want this for me and my kids?
So I'm all about experiences. I'm all about creating experiences that lead to memories. And I felt that that doing this together as a family, it gives us an opportunity to really, to create an experience and then the skills to create a lot more down the road. And definitely did. I think that the opportunity for the girls, especially to get to know each other, I think was very fun for them and something new that, you know, we're sort of in an area that's sometimes a little lonely, can be. So I thought that was a terrific opportunity. But I loved the idea, really, bottom line, of capturing, of teaching them skills that they can then capture memories and experiences. And and it's terrific. And, you know, I think they're a little slow, or maybe it was our schedule, it was a little slow on the uptake, but we are getting ready to do a big trip this fall. And I'm like, oh God, you're so over this is exactly what you're going to be doing. So I'm super excited about it. Yeah.
Yes. That is so exciting to hear. And it just warms my heart so much to know that what you and your kids have been learning, you're going to now mm-hmm. put into practice in real life as mm-hmm. they're experiencing these things for the first time and being able to capture their voices and their faces and their physicality with technology and then share that with other homeschoolers, other families who want to create these really rich, robust experiences with their kids. Podcasting and video is the best way to do that.
Yes. And, you know, also, if you think about it, it's not just it's as you beautifully laid out in the course, it's about writing scripts. It's about being able to, you know, you're combining different skills that really, really work so well with your academics. So it's writing the scripts, it's reading the material, it's putting everything together. That it does require a little maturity, which we won't talk about that right part of that particular now. But I think that the skill set that is required is so, it connects beautifully with what they're supposed to be doing at this age in school and just does it in a more creative way.
Yes, and thank you for bringing that up because a lot of parents will ask me, you know, why should I podcast with my kids? You know, what is the benefit? And like you just said, there's so many tie-ins to what they're doing academically, plus socially. It opens up a whole new world of social connections they can be making, especially when you're doing things like homeschooling, where you want them to connect with the outside world and speak to different people who've had different experiences. And everything from the math of a podcast on how to put it together, calculating that, projecting out to the future, goal setting, writing scripts, editing scripts, becoming a better storyteller. These are all things that our kids can now take into the future with them. It's going to serve them so well when they can go to a job interview or open up their first business and know that they have the skills to make that happen. And I just love watching that unfold.
Oh my gosh, that is exactly. And it's also, you know, it's teaching skills that can differentiate them when they're going to college. But there's nothing, you know, you've hit the nail on the head in terms of the skills that you need really ultimately to get a job. Yeah. And I laugh because I look at my husband who is a retired military officer and an engineer. And generally you don't think of a lot of techies, not really techie skills, but, you know, I look at actually while he was watching the kid and working with the kids as well, that these are the skills that life learning skills that you have to have. And it helps boost your career. I get all excited about this and then, you know, start rambling. So. But no, I'm so excited that the kids were able to take part in it. And I thought, like, I could see my daughter was very social. She's the social one. And my son is more into, okay, what do I need to download? How do I need to do this? Yes. I can do an intro. How fast can I do an intro? Those sort of things. So it was very neat to watch both of them go through this. And, you know, they still do their YouTube things. And yeah, it's really exciting.
And the other day when we were chatting, you shared a story and I just had to giggle a little bit about it because you said that your son, when he was going through this course and this experience, he was binge watching. And I think that's so funny and it's so unique to this generation and in our vernacular these days that we can sit and binge watch something. And then at the end of that binge watching session, unlike Netflix or Hulu, at the end of this binge watching session, there's something that you have created. And I think that's so, so profound.
Oh, yeah. No, and it was funny that just sat down and knocked it out because I had been saying, you know, you need to keep up, you need to do this, we need to do that. But I think that just in their particular, his particular learning style, he was off and running and he was like, oh, this is great. I don't know. So yeah, I was really glad that there was flexibility in the course that we were able to do that as well. And, you know, so Becca who liked to do the study halls and things of that nature. And whereas Jake was much, you know, he was happy to binge watch.
And I love that. Yeah. So when we set out to creating this experience for families, knowing the kids have to do their work and parents are doing their part to make all this happen, we really mm-hmm. thought about creating that depth of, you know, how can we create this so that any style of learner, whether they like mm-hmm. to binge watch the videos, whether they like to interact and ask questions, how can we make it accessible for all those types of learners so they can all get a benefit from it?
Yeah, no, that's really a wonderful, wonderful option to give to parents for their kids. Yes, wonderful option.
Well, thank you. I would love to know, and I'm sure our listeners and viewers would love to know, as a mom with twins, how did this experience of creating this project, this podcast together, what was that experience like for you?
It was fun. I mean, it was fun. I really enjoyed kind of trying to get into the weeds with them. And seeing also, I love watching how their minds start to work and watch the engine start to go. And yeah. I think that that was really what was exciting for me is what can you come up with and what can you produce and where do you want to go? And hi, Leslie. I love that. It gives us an opportunity now where I can say, hey, why aren't you recording that? Or why aren't you doing this? And as I said, we're getting ready to take a trip. And I'm really excited about seeing how we're going to take it to the next step. So, yeah. And it's just, there's so many, as a working mom, there's not always a lot of time. And I loved that we carved out time together to spend. And I think that was really important. And it wasn't like it was a tremendous amount of time, and it fit beautifully in with our existing schedule. So, but you know, the opportunity to do things where they're not, a lot of what they do now in school is just themselves, and it's just solo. And I love being able to share with them.
I love hearing that you were able to carve out that time to do stuff together, because as our kids get older, they tend to grow out of us. They don't want to spend as much time with us. So if we can preserve that for even a little while longer, that's so valuable for us as moms, as parents, and for our kids as well, because they're going to look back 20 years from now and remember the times when you were laughing and giggling in your PJs and you were recording some silly story to share on a podcast or a video. What all of this has been about.
Yeah, I think a couple times we were like in a hotel room. It was a lot of fun. And I don't see, you know, I love being able to incorporate fun into what we do because, you know, it makes it more enjoyable, but also I don't see anything wrong in them. Everything doesn't have to be hard.
Yes. and I think fun too is something that we forget to do sometimes, right? We forget to carve out those spaces where, you know, we're just go, 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 go. We're taking our kids from point A to point B to point C. We're doing things in our business and we're very busy, but looking back, there's not a lot of real stuff that gets done, and it definitely is fun. So if we can lead with fun, how do we make this fun? Because that being in that state of mind definitely opens us up to the possibilities, the experiences that we can not only enjoy ourselves, but we can create and share with others.
Exactly. Exactly. Just what you said. Exactly.
So I would love to know, you mentioned earlier that your kids learn differently, and one of them was like the social aspects of it, one of them liked the binge watching aspects. As a mom who's now homeschooling, what have your kids learned? Like, what are things that you see them doing now that maybe they weren't doing before?
I think they're, you know, okay, there's also a discipline to this. Mm-hmm. There's no question. And that is not necessarily something that that they were particularly good at. Like if you're assigned a project in school, you know, it may be fun and creative to get it done, but you're assigned it and then it's due. And the course showed them how to do steps to, and then you have a final project, your final product. And I mm-hmm. think that was really super helpful to show them step by step by step. And that is something that I, you know, now encourage them to continue to do with what they do. And that was really super helpful to lay out. You laid out a beautifully laid out course.
Well, thank you again for those kind words. It's always so much fun to get feedback, you know, as we're creating things in our own minds and, you know, we envision them to be a certain way, but then to come on the other side and talk to people who've had the experience with us, such a cool, like, exciting place to be, knowing that you and your kids, you know, got benefit out of going through this 8-week experience, and, you know, you're building on it now as you're getting ready to travel this fall and have a pretty epic adventure and go to some really historical places where so many great stories can be told.
Exactly. And to have the skills that allow them. And the thing is, it's great for, you know, if they want to monetize what they've learned, but also to have the skills to just be able to tell their stories. And those are invaluable. They both like to write, but this allows an entire multimedia, multi-sensory experience that I think in the long run is really pretty incredible that they're learning these skills now as middle schoolers.
Yes, absolutely. Because I think as new technology continues to emerge, and our kids are really this first generation of digital natives, where they're growing up with all this technology and seeing it change and seeing it morph. And I get so excited about showing them what's possible now, but above and beyond that, about let's open these doors. Let's see what's behind door number one and see what that experience is like, and door number two and three and so on. And then being able to put those skills together to be on the forefront of creating new technology, to be creating a place where kids of their own generation, you know, where they're leading the charge in sharing their voices, being a beacon of light in the world, showing other kids that just because you're a kid doesn't mean you don't have a story to share. And this is really what the conversation the other day was all about how do we now amplify this? Once we have kids learning and they are confident in sharing their voices, whether that's through audio, whether that's through the written word, maybe it's video, maybe it's the production aspects, how can we now take that and amplify that? So I'm excited to pursue that more because just to put a little FYI out there, that in the future, Wendy and I would love to make this a really experiential thing for kids and families, where we go on location to different amazing places, go serve those communities, learn to do these skills, and then learn to be master storytellers through our chosen mediums.
Yes. I mean, I'm still excited about whether it is doing volunteer work in, anywhere. We can do volunteer work and having the kids be able to capture that as well, to their interaction and relationship with, like, grandparents. That one really, you know, what the opportunity to create a lasting, some sort of a video of conversations. Oh, I just, like, I get goosebumps that the kids have this opportunity, and it's really amazing. And I cannot wait. selfishly speaking, for my kids to be able to do these things.
Yes, mine as well. There's so much potential. I mean, technology allows us to connect in real time. Yes. But if we, again, use technology to now make our world much smaller by being able to go to these exotic places and see what another culture is all about and share what their day looks like. You know, what do their kids do all day? And then to not only document that, but to understand that as people on this planet, we're gifted to gift to be here. And it's our gift to be able to use our voices to then broadcast to the world about the changes we can make. You know, what our responsibility on this planet could look like. And that is just such an exciting, like, it's such an exciting time to be alive and to guide our kids through this time when, gosh, I mean, there's limitless possibilities. And you said at the very beginning, we're only limited by our imagination. So by getting our kids to use their imagination more,
exactly, I mean,
that's going to be where everything comes together so beautifully.
Exactly. There's absolutely no question. And as I listen to you talk, I immediately think about everything from pyramids to tagging sea turtles to going to the pyramids in Mexico, pyramids in Egypt. My mind just goes wow, the silverback gorillas in Rwanda. I'm ready. Yeah.
Yes, and you mentioned the other day the Galapagos Islands, and I thought,
Exactly. The Galapagos and Easter Island. Can you imagine kids trying to understand the magnitude and significance? And it's amazing. And for adults, I love being able to see things through their eyes. Because they have a different, and the questions that they ask, and most of the time, the level of understanding that kids have is just amazing. It's generally a little, it can be simple yet so intense. Mm-hmm. And I absolutely love it. And it's so energizing, to see how they respond to everything these days. And it's just giving them the opportunities to do it. And I think that's really the thing. I feel very lucky and very blessed that I'm able to give my kids the opportunities and feel that if parents can do it, I can't recommend it more. I can recommend it a lot more, but
amazing, you know what I'm trying to say. Next question. If there's someone watching on the live broadcast, on the replay, or listening over on the podcast, and they're excited about what we're sharing today, what would your recommendation to them be about taking a next step?
Well, I would say they need to contact you right away. And really, to contact you and see what the opportunities are available. And also, just sit down and just carve out a little bit of time with your kids. Mm-hmm. It is absolutely invaluable, and the experiences are just, really, when we sat down, we carved out time, we talked about what was your overall theme going to be, what are you looking to achieve, and there's those possibilities are endless, and it really is. It is an amazing opportunity to share with your kids because, most, and even at this age, a lot of homeschool is done individually and it's solo. This is really an opportunity to share. And I'm so glad that I did. They're learning really invaluable skills that, as whether you monetize it now or you see it in the future, this is really important, really important for them to know. So I would definitely say for parents to get in touch with you and sign up.
Oh, so beautifully said. You cannot know how impactful this story of yours is to hear.
Well, And I can add that we've signed up for like the second part.
So yes, there's more to come. So be on the lookout.
Exactly.
So kids to see what comes next.
Yeah. So it's very exciting.
Yes. And so I would love to make sure people know where to find you, because you are the travel maven, the travel guru. And now that we've been talking about possibilities of taking what we do with kids on the road and traveling, you definitely want to go connect with Wendy. Mm-hmm. Where can everyone find you?
So the easiest place to find me is on Facebook. My Facebook page is Rebel on the Go. And then from there, I actually have a Facebook group that is filled with just some absolutely incredibly fun and exciting women who, whether they're looking to travel right now or just dreaming about it a little bit, either is just fine. And we have some really fabulous conversations. And yeah, so, and then from the Facebook page, there's just a button that says join the group.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Wendy, I want to thank you so much.
Well, thank you.
Coming back to report on your experience going through this process of learning to podcast for your kids, with your kids, and now to see what's going to be next as this new chapter unfolds for all of you.
It's going to be fun.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. And if you're listening on the podcast, if you're listening on the replay, let us know you're here. Ask any questions that you have. And be on the lookout for what is coming up next here at Our Young Creators, from becoming a podcast family to being able to take that on the road. Reach out to me, send me a message, send Wendy a message if you have questions about traveling. And I want to thank you all for taking time out of your day to spend with us today. I want to give a shout out to Deb LaFlamme and Leslie Laws, who are both tuning in live. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for your emojis. We so appreciate it. And my friends, I will catch you all very soon. Cheers.